needle so fine. I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. Far over the waters, I'd reach my magic band to every human being, so they would understand, so they'd understand. Something new has been added, but I'm here not to show you what I can do on the piano, or rather what I cannot do, but because an old friend of mine is going to be here with us today, and she usually sings with the piano, so I say, okay, we'll bring a piano in. Move the table out, and in comes the piano. It's a great instrument. Great instrument. I can make noise on a piano, but I can't make music on it. Oh, I can try. You can get a lot of loud tone on it, but get music is a little bit more difficult. But sometimes I've heard music on the piano I love so much, I can't let it alone. 25 years ago in the army, I was walking down between barracks and there's a piano inside. And a fellow was practicing Johann Sebastian Bach. Inside and said, what the heck piece is that? Oh, he said, it's part of a long chorale, and this is the organ part. I couldn't get it out of my head. I wrote away to Schirmer and said, send me that music. And before I was out of the army, well, I had figured out how to play it after a fashion on the banjo. Though I'm gonna get in tune before I play this. There, now we're in good temper. Bach, you know, he wrote the well-tempered clavichord, and this is gonna be the good-tempered banjo. I don't think old Johann Sebastian Bach would feel insulted. He'd be glad to have his music played on all kinds of instruments. And I think as the centuries go by, they will be. I don't play that usually in public. Mostly I play it for my own comfort and amusement when I'm by myself. A couple other tunes I like very much. This one used to be played by a whole symphony orchestra. Thank you. I don't know, maybe old Ludwig von Beethoven is rolling over in his grave. He wasn't quite such a charitable man when it came to other people monkeying with his music. He knew what he wanted. And he never suspected that a banjo would be trying to play that melody from his Fifth Symphony. But you know, musicians have been swiping from each other as long as there's been music in this world. A fellow hears a nice tune somewhere, he's going to play it his own way. Whether he's a classical musician, a jazz musician, or a folk musician, east, west, north, or south. And many a tune that we think is a great symphony melody was once a folk melody. And who knows but what some of the pop tunes whistled by the kids may have been a symphony tune one day, just got rearranged. So I don't think it's out of place at all to have this piano here today. I'm asking Martha Schlamme to sing you some songs. Let me tell you a little about her, so she won't have to tell you herself, because she was born and raised in the city of Vienna, same city where Beethoven did his composing. And then Hitler came along. She fled. She went to England, and later on came to this country. Like many European people, she knows many different kinds of music, many, many different kinds. But I'll let her show you that in person, so just a moment. Next, sitting down at this piano stool is going to be Martha Schlamme. I'll be standing up here talking with her. See you then.
You know, Pete, just to avoid getting millions of letters from your listeners, I have to tell you that that was not from the Fifth Beethoven Symphony, but the Seventh.
Okay. Oh, yes, the Fifth is the one that goes boom, 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 boom.
Right.
Fate punching you on the nose. Okay, Seventh. Right. I'll remember it next
Sorry,
time.
Sorry, I'm not trying to show off.
You well, it's good music, whether it's the Fifth or the Sixth or the Seventh or Eighth or Twelfth or Thirteenth. Martha, do you remember the first time we met when the Weavers were forming as a quartet and we had a little basement hootenanny and in you walked? And us with our banjos and guitars asked you to sing, and you said, well, and all of a sudden we started improvising an accompaniment to you. I remember a song you sang in those days. It was a French folk song about the prisoner of Nantes. Do you remember just a verse of it? Let me see if I can remember the accompaniment we worked out.
Prison de Nantes, il y a un prisonnier, il y a un prisonnier que personne n'y va voir que la fille du geôlier. Ah, 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 ah.
I've never forgotten it. It's such a nice accompaniment.
Do you know what I remember from that occasion? Well, I was of course spellbound by the Weavers and your banjo playing and all those gorgeous songs. And I said, I'd like to hear you all again. And you said, we have to get together and, what's the word? I can't remember now, swap songs? Swap songs.
Oh.
And I'd never heard that word. And before I left, I said, all right, Pete, we'll get together and swipe songs. And I'm still swiping songs.
Well, that's simpler. Very, very, very true.
Only we call it researching.
Yeah, that's right. Lee would say, this is an old song we collected in the sense of stole.
That's right.
Well, I'm glad that musicians keep swapping and swiping from each other, because without that, music wouldn't be what it is. I've also been looking forward to having you on the program so that people could get an idea of the many different kinds of music which can be included in this whole category of songs that people sing. I've heard you sing in German, in Hebrew, in Yiddish, and I don't know exactly what you're going to do today, but it's up to you.
Okay. Well, you know, you mentioned before that I was born in Vienna, and one of the many things that happen to people born in Vienna is that they take classical music absolutely for granted. You know, I used to hum songs by Schubert and Mozart, and I used never to know that anyone had written them, you know. And equally, I used to sing songs like Und der Haifisch, der hat Zähne, und die trägt im Gesicht. Well, so I didn't know that it was written by Kurt Weill and Bertolt Brecht, you know, two Germans, two anti-fascists who also fled from Germany and found refuge in other countries and became terribly famous in this country, as you probably know. And I have begun to include these songs, which were my folklore, in my folk song recitals, you see? And great. I thought perhaps that I would do two songs for you from two of the different shows that they wrote, for which purpose I brought along a brilliant young man by the name of Abraham Stockman.
All right.
This is Pete Seeger. This is Abe Stockman.
Hi. Glad to meet you.
And I thought we'd do one song from the beloved Three Penny Opera, which an American composer, Mark Blitzstein, has adapted rather magnificently. I'm glad to say he didn't translate, he just adapted. The song we're going to do was sung in the original version by Polly Peachum on the day of her marriage to the notorious Mac the Knife McKeith. And they have no money, so they cannot hire professional entertainment, and so Polly offers to entertain her guests. And she tells her guests about a little barmaid in Soho who scrubs and cleans day in, day out, year in, year out. The people laugh at her, taunt her, humiliate her. She never says anything at all, but her heart is filled with bitterness and hatred. And in her mind there is a fantasy, a very vivid fantasy, of a ship that will come along one day, and she will be its captain, the pirate Jenny, and the ship will take her to a distant land where no one will ever be able to humiliate her again. You gentlemen can watch while I'm scrubbing the floors. I'm scrubbing the floors while you're gawking. And maybe once you tip me and it makes you feel swell on a ratty waterfront in a ratty old hotel, you never guess to who you're talking. And you never guess to who you're talking. Suddenly one night there's a scream in the night and you yell, who the hell could that have been? And you see me kind of grinning while I'm scrubbing. And you say, what the hell's she got to grin? And a ship, a black freighter with a skull on its masthead will be coming in. Then you gentlemen can say, hey girl, finish the floor, run upstairs, make the beds, earn your keep here. And you toss me your tips and look out at the ships, but I'm counting your heads while I make up the beds, 'cause there's nobody going to sleep here. Tonight, none of you will sleep here. Then that night, there's a bang in the night, and you yell, who's that kicking up a row? And you see me kind of staring out the window, and you say, what she got to stare at now? And the ship, the black freighter, turns around in the harbor, shooting guns from the bow. Then you gentlemen can wipe off the laugh from your face. Every building in town's a flat one. Your whole stinking place will be down to the ground. Only this cheap hotel standing up safe and sound. You yell, why the hell spare that one? And you yell, why the hell spare that one? All the night through with the noise and to do, you wonder who's the person lives up there. Then you see me stepping out into the morning, looking nice with a ribbon in my hair. and the ship, the black freighter, runs the flag up its masthead, and a cheer rings the air. And the other song we have chosen is not sung by a bitter woman, but a rather nostalgic one. This comes from a play called Happy End. Apparently, Mr. Brecht was fascinated by America and wrote what is generally considered to be a German version of Guys and Dolls. In the words of Will Holt, the characters of this play are all cops and robbers, Salvation Army girls, and not so Salvation Army girls. We find this woman in a crowded barroom, and she says, you know, Bill's dance hall in Bilbao was the greatest on the whole continent. There you could get for $1 anything your heart desired. Maybe you wouldn't have liked it there, but I tell you, it was the greatest. I mean, everywhere we sat, the whiskey just flowed. On the dance floor, the grass grew. Through a leaking roof, you could see a green moon. And the music. Let's see, how did it go? The old Bilbao moon, that's where love was. Something like that. It's so long ago, I can't remember the words anymore, but I tell you, it was beautiful. That day when these guys came from Frisco with bags of money, there was shooting, there was love. Those were the days. I mean, if you saw it today, you wouldn't believe it. They fixed it up. They cleared off the floor. They called off the green moon. Now they serve ice cream. There are palm trees, just like any other ordinary establishment. Well, it's quite possible that you would like it better this way. But I tell you, for me, the old Bilbao moon was the greatest in the whole wide world.
War das Schönste auf dem ganzen Kontinent. Da gab's für einen Dollar Krach und Wonne, Krach und Wonne, Krach und Wonne. Und was die Welt ja eigen nennt. Aber wenn sie da hereingekommen wären, ich weiß ja nicht, ob ihnen sowas gerade gefällt. Ach, brenn die Lachen waren, wo man saß. Auf dem Tanzboden wuchs das Gras. Und der grüne Mond schien durch das Dach. Ne Musik gab's da. Da wurde was geboten für sein Geld. Hey Joe, mach die Musik von damals nach. Alte Bilbauer Mond, da wo noch? Halt, wie ging das mit dem Text jetzt? Ha. Ist schon so lang her. Ich weiß ja nicht, ob Ihnen sowas gerade gefällt. Es war das Schönste.
Beste auf der Welt. Willst Ballhaus in Bilbao, Bilbao, Bilbao. An dem Tage Ende Mai im Jahre 8, da kamen wir aus Frisco mit einem Geldsack, mit einem Geldsack, mit einem Geldsack. Die haben damals mit uns was gemacht. Aber wenn sie da hereingekommen wären, ich weiß ja nicht, ob ihnen sowas gerade gefällt. Ach, brenn, die Lachen waren, wo man saß. Auf dem Tanzboden wuchs das Gras. Und der grüne Mond schien durch das Dach. Und vier Herren konnten sie da mit ihrem Browning schießen hören. Sind sie ein Held? Na, dann machen sie es mal nach. Aber wenn sie da hereingesegelt werden, es ist ja möglich, dass es ihnen so gefällt. Aber mir macht sowas keinen Spaß. Auf dem Tanzboden wächst kein Gras. Und der grüne Mond ist abbestellt. Ne Musik machen sie da. Da kann man sich nur schämen für sein Geld. Hey Joe, mach die Musik von damals nach. Alter Bilbao. Alte Bilbao-Mond, mich hat nie geschont. Ich weiß ja nicht, ob Ihnen sowas grad gefällt. Doch es war das Schönste, es war das Schönste, es war das Schönste.
I was very interested to hear you singing in German. I have to confess, I never really did get the German language. Maybe it's because I had to study it when I was in school.
I'm glad I never had to study it. That's one language I couldn't ever learn.
You remember Mark Twain's famous statement? He said, a German sentence dives under the Atlantic and comes up on the other side with a verb in its mouth.
That's very good.
But nevertheless, I remember I once recorded with you a whole album of German songs on the banjo. Trouble is we didn't have any bass. I tell you, let's try one of those songs again, and this time, well, you improvise. I think this is a key of E flat. What's your E flat? Wenn alle Brünnlein fließen, what does it mean?
When all brooks are flowing, a terrible translation. When brooks are flowing?
And what goes on then?
Dann muss ich grüßen, then I have to say farewell. And I go, I leave.
In other words, in the springtime when things melt.
Yes, I have to go away. You know, the restless spring
wanderer.
Okay, when winter is gone and the ice melts, then I'm going to be running off, dearie.
Something.
Here we go.
Wenn alle Brünnlein fließen, da muss ich winken. Wenn ich mein Schatz nicht rufen darf, mit den Augenlein und treten mit den Fuß.
it says anywhere.
A friend of mine, you know, is over in Germany now playing the banjo all over the place. And you never can tell what's going to happen. 50 years from now, these songs may be accompanied by a banjo too, as well as piano. Of course, for some songs, banjo is too sparkly, too prickly. And I've heard you sing some very quiet, lovely old songs, which I brought along a wooden whistle, maybe if I could help you on. Do you know the one I'm thinking of?
Yes. This is a Yiddish song. Actually, you know, it's one of those cases where it isn't a folk song, and yet it is, if you know what I mean. It was written by Mordechai Gibirtik, who unfortunately lost his life in one of the concentration camps in Poland. And he writes songs that really feel like they always existed, if you know what I mean. I mean, I know the people he writes about. Especially in this one, he writes about this woman who is singing her baby to sleep. And I think maybe for people who don't understand Yiddish, it's enough to know that she is probably the originator of the phrase, my son the doctor. Does that make sense?
Schlafe mir mein Jankele, mein Schäne. Die Egel auf die Schwarzinke macht zu. A jingele, wo so schön alle Zendele, muss noch die Mame singen, ay lulu. A jingele, wo so schön alle Zendele, muss noch die Mame singen, ay lulu. A jingele, wo so schön alle Zendele, und wird mit Masel bald in Cheder gehen, und lernen wird der Chumisch und Gemorre, soll weinen, wenn die Mami wiegt ihm ein. Und lernen wird der Chumme schon gemorre. Soll weinen, wenn die Mami wiegt ihm ein. A jingale, wo's lernen wird gemorre. Ot steht die Mami quält und hört sich zu. A jingale, wo's wächst dat han mit Choche. Los ganzer nach der Mami nicht zu ruh. A jingale, wo's wächst dat all mit Choche, los ganze noch der Mami nicht zur Ruh. A jingale, wo's wächst dat all mit Choche, und a genit der Seuche recht zugleich. A jingale, a kluger Chossenboche, soll liegen a so nass wie in a Teich. A jingale, a kluger Chossenboche, so liegen wir so in nass wie in a Teich. Nu schlupfe mir mein kluger Chossenboche, derweil liegst du in Wigale bei mir. Es wird kosten noch viel mir und Mames Träern, bis wann es wird ein Mensch raus von dir. Es wird kosten noch viel mir und Mamis Träern, bis wann ins Vitam Mensch arruis von
dir. I don't know if we put any babies to sleep or not.
It's such, I adore that so much because the poetry is also so exquisite. You know, she says, stop crying, you're going to be a marvelous student and you're going to be a wise man. And already I can hear you recite the Talmud, and you're going to be a marvelous merchant, and you're a bridegroom, and you're still wet in your cradle. And then she comes back to herself and she reminds herself that it will be quite a while yet before he will be either one of those things, and it will cost a lot of mother's tears before he will be a real human being, or a man, you know.
When you sing some of these old Yiddish songs for your Jewish audiences, do they take offense when you sing a German song?
Yes, I'm afraid they do. It's something I emotionally understand, because it took me a while to overcome you know, the hatred. But I never hated the German language. It, after all, preceded Hitler. You know, it's the language of Heine, of Goethe, of Schiller. And, you know, I've made an adjustment. I feel it is my mother tongue. It's a beautiful language. There's been tremendous literature written in German. And it would be like having been defeated by Hitler, after all, if you cut out a language, isn't it? Wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I mean,
true.
You know, he practically destroyed everything that was good. He didn't destroy us, we survived, and so did the language, and so did the music. And so I sing it with a great deal of love, as a matter of fact. You know.
I think eventually people will realize that all these things can be side by side. That's really what this show is all about, you know, the rainbow quest. All the different colors side by side. You had some other old Yiddish songs you could sing?
Yes, can I do one where I can move around? I'd like to do a children's song about a group of children who are playing a dancing game in the street. After each round, one of the children has to leave the circle, and the one who's left behind has won. Well, it's a game that's played all over the world. These children are having very weighty discussions whilst they're playing. One of them is saying, it is better to marry a malamet, that's a teacher, even if he is a cross one, than a student with torn trousers. Or it is better to marry a widower with 12 little children than a doctor with a broken down top hat and wisdom like that.
Schön bin ich schön, schön ist mein Nomen, redt man mir schädig im von Samir Rabonim, Rabonische Teure ist doch sehr groß, bin ich bei meinem Mann in der lechtige Reuse. Schön bin ich, bin ich, heute ist ein Gelach, trag ich Geld in die Taschen, Wein in die Flaschen, Milch in die Kriegerlach, Kinder in die Wiegerlach, schreien alle schön, schön bin ich schön. Student mit zerrissen Nasen, besserer Behelfer mit uns kleine Kinder, ne der Gora Doktor mit der zerbrochenen Zylinder. Schön bin ich, bin ich, heute ist ein Gelach, trag ich Geld in die Taschen, Wein in die Flaschen, Milch in die Kriegerlach, Kinder in die Wiegerlach, schreien alle schön, schön bin ich schön. Besserer Prostor Klößnick, a viele nicht kein Guter, Neder an Apteke, wo's prägelt Fleisch auf Butter. Ich will nehmen nach Hause mit der Pollen Gepäes und wird mir bringen von unserem Kamees. Ach, schön, Mädele, bin ich. Heute ist ein Gelach, trag ich Geld in die Taschen, Wein in die Flaschen, Milch in die Kriegerloch, Kinder in die Wiegerloch, schreien alle schön, schön bin ich schön. Well, you know, in Eastern Europe, people had to do an awful lot of laughing to keep from crying. And somehow, they sort of made fun of themselves and managed to stop crying. And there's a marvelous song about a poor old lady who runs out into the marketplace and she says, "Stop the thief. Maybe he will admit it. He has robbed me of all my possessions, my broken dishes, my torn shirts, and even my ugly seven daughters." It's quite a tragedy. Hopzum bin zum Hopzum bin zum Hopzum bin zum Satz zum mein Fscher wird das heute sein. Oi gewolt kann ich hat doch mir begann wird hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen oi was oi sieht mein Hände wie die Becher drei mit Lattes und vier mit Lecher oi gewolt kann ich doch mir begann wird, hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen, hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen, alles fin mein Stieb. Hopp zu mir bin zum, hopp zu mir bin zum, hopp zu mir bin zum, setz zu mein, fscher wird das auch meide sein, hoi, gewalt der Kampf, hat doch mir begann wird, hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen, hat dabei mir ziegen nehmen, oi, was, oi, sieben, lei, Töchter wie die Birn, drei und fies und vier und rehr, neu gewalter Ganef, er hat doch mir begonnen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, alles fin mein Stieb. Hopp zum Winzum, hopp zum Winzum, hopp zum Winzum, setze mein Efscher, wird das auch mal design, neu gewalter Ganef, er hat doch mir begonnen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, neu was. Oi sieben Mädchen wie die Sosnes, drei und zehn und vier und Josles. Sei gewalter Kanef, er hat doch mir begonnen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, er hat doch bei mir Ziegen nehmen, alles fin mein Stieb bei Gewalt.
Ah, wonderful. Now we're going to ask you to stick around for a moment because we have still a few more songs before this program's over. Some that Martha Schlamme and I did years ago. And some that are as new, well, you'll hear them. Just a moment.
Would you sing a song for me now?
Got any request?
Yes, I have a request. I love East Virginia. Would you do it?
All right, well, it's a favorite song of mine, too, if I say so myself. I sang it on this program a month or two ago, but I'll play it again. Some pretty little woman, her name and age I do not know. Well, her hair it was of a light brown color. She wore white lilies where I long to lay my head. Well, I'd rather be in some dark holler where the sun would never shine. Some pretty little woman, her name and age I do not know.
Thank you very much.
Well, born in East Virginia, North Carolina, I did go. This world's full of people being born in one place and going somewhere else.
So the passion of that is so marvelous,
mm-hmm.
isn't it?
Yes. Well, is music supposed to have some passion in it?
Yeah.
When you were born in Vienna and then you went somewhere else, where did you go first?
Well, we fled, you know, all separately. My father was in a camp and my mother went to England. And I had relatives in France. I fled to France first. And then we got to England. And then because we were strictly speaking Germans, you know, technically speaking, we were of course Germans. So there was chaos in England at the beginning of the war. So they interned people, you know, just indiscriminately at first. They interned them until they could clear them. And that was really, well, they treated us all right, I guess, but it was, you know, it was painful because it was so, the mishmash of people, you know, people from refugees from Spain, communists, fascists, Jews, anything, you know, anybody who wasn't
Spain
British.
Up there?
Spain too, yes. And as a matter of fact, you know, I remember when I came to America the first time, that famous day when I heard the Weavers for the first time, you sang a song that I had heard in the internment camp.
Oh, be darned. What was it?
That Venga Jaleo. Yeah, I was quite shocked to hear it. I thought, you know, that this wouldn't be known outside of Spain, but of course these songs get around. And
what key do you do it in?
G minor.
Yes. Let me see if I can get there. Wait a moment, wait a moment. This is going to take some clapping.
While you do that, should I say what it's about?
Yes, tell them the meaning of the words.
It says, on the 18th of July, in a little patio of a convent in Madrid, the 15th Brigade was formed, and it dedicated itself to the total defeat of Franco and fascism. Something like that.
El yeso chorea de julio en el patio de un convento, un pueblo madrileño fundó el quinto regimiento. Venga, frío, frío, sueña de la ametralladora y Franco se va a paseo y
said we were singing old songs and new, and they really are both at the same time, because when I sing a song like that, I think this is for today's headlines. And there's another song that both Martha Schlamme and I knew, which was made up back in the days of Hitler, and we thought we'd sing it for you, because it also is as new as today's headlines, even though it was put together in 1934. It was made up in the concentration camp of Borgersmoor. Borgersmoor, Western Germany, western part of Germany. And a miner by the name of Esser, I think that was his name, Martin Esser. He made a verse up. Can't remember the exact German, because I first learned it in English translation. He took this verse. It said, far and wide goes the fields, and we go out to dig peat. And then it said, we are the peat bog soldiers.
marching with our spades to the bog. He took his verse to a musician who was also in the same concentration camp, and they called a little group together that evening, about 10 of them, and made up a tune for it, and then some extra verses. And I've seen a reproduction of the songbook that was hand-lettered in the prison. The song became very popular, and then the Germans found out what the words really meant, and they forbade the Nazis found out what the words really meant, and they forbade the prisoners to sing it. And the song is now all around the world. Far and wide as the eye can wander, heath and bog are everywhere. Not a bird sings out to cheer us. Oaks are standing gaunt and bare. We are the peat bog soldiers, marching with our spades to the bog. Wir sind die Moorsoldaten und ziehen mit den Spaten ins Moor. Sing the second verse, Martha.
Up and down the guards are pacing. No one can get through. Flight would mean a sure death facing. Guns and barbed wire greet our wound.
We are the people. Bog soldiers marching with our spades to the bog. Wir sind die Moorsoldaten und ziehen mit den Spaten ins Moor. But for us there is no complaining. Winter will in time be past. Someday we shall cry rejoicing, homeland dear, you're mine at last. We will the peat bog soldiers, marching with our spades to the bog. This in the we really ought to dedicate that song not to all the people of Germany who went through the concentration camps, but people who go to concentration camps in any country. Maybe for people anywhere, everywhere who are willing to go to prison to try and say that their country is doing wrong and should be doing right, because that's what those Germans were doing that were in the concentration camp. They were trying to say that fascism was wrong. We are the peat bog soldiers, marching with our spades to the bog. We are the
had I a golden thread and needle so fine, I'd weave a magic strand of rainbow design, of rainbow design. In it I'd weave the bravery of women giving birth. In it I'd weave the innocence of children over all the earth, children of all earth. Far over the water, I magic band to every city through every single land through every land show my brothers and my sisters my